this video, I'm going to show you how to create a WinP ISO image that you can use to build a physical or a virtual machine to capture its contents and create a WIM file, a Windows image file, that you can deploy to other machines on your network. To do this, the first step is to create the ISO file, and assuming that you have installed the Windows Automated Installation Kit, of which there are two versions, the Vista and the Windows 7 version, you can go to the command prompt and then to the location of the Windows Automated Installation Kit, and we can use a batch file that is provided within the AIK to create the ISO file. Now, the only difference in this ISO that we will create to image the contents, image the operating system customized with applications and other settings on a Windows 7 machine will be the addition of the ImageX tool. We will just copy that to the WinP folder before we create the ISO image. Now, this batch file that I've just mentioned exists under PE Tools directory in the Windows 7 version. And the only thing that we provide this batch file with is the architecture of the target machine that we're going to run it on. If it doesn't support x64, just provide x86, 32-bit, and then specify a directory under which you want to copy the PE files to, and we will use the contents of this folder to create the ISO image. Once the files are copied, the only thing we will do is go back to the Windows AIK, and from this location I will copy the ImageX tool to the WinP folder. I'm going to copy that to the ISO folder, and as you can see, I haven't created the WinP or the ISO folders. The folder structure has been automatically created by the tool itself. So if you go there and look at the structure, this is what it looks like. And once I've done that, what I'm going to do is run a tool called the OSCD IMG executable, and with this I'm going to be specifying the WinP boot image, the etfsboot.com file, and then the ISO folder, which contains the contents of the CD-ROM, and also specify a target file for the WinP image that we are going to create. It's pretty quick. It's created the WinP ISO file, and with that, you can start a Windows 7 machine and copy the contents of it.